want to dedicate myself, and also I insist others to dedicate themselves for this noblest cause, which has incarnated for purification of the soul, universe, and also that I have already told in one lecture about Periyarvar's approach towards the greatness of Bhagavad Bhakti, and he also curses the persons who are not devoted to God. He is saying that Unnum Soru, Udukum Kurayum, Yanna Bhavam Shidara Dangolo, he is saying. The persons who are not devoted to God, they are not only sinful. Whatever the food that they consume and whatever the dress that they wear, those things are also even sinful. Sinful to the core. That's what he is blaming. Manavada Mamunihil is explaining here how it can be sinful. Both these things are insentient, jata. Punya and papa is meant only for species, that is exalted species like human beings. How you can attribute this punya and papa to just insentient things such as food and clothes, which are nothing but inanimate matter? How it could be possible? And he explains that even though they are inanimate, they are governed by an animate possession, anupravesha. Even those things, they possess life. What is the difference between these two lives? This life is having productive consciousness, and that is having receptive consciousness, which is parapsychology, which we will deal later. So, even we believe there is a book. The book is inanimate. But we believe that there is some deity which is governing the book, which is animate, Saraswati. There is rain, which is inanimate. Why we are invoking rain? There is a question asked by so many other skeptic persons in Brahma Sutra. They are asking, the Vedic statements are non-believable and they are very childish. It just says that dust spake, the fire, and water spoke, and then rain spoke. How it is possible? These things are inanimate things. How rain can speak to a person? Vyasa answers, Abhimani Vyapadeshastu Visheshanugati Bhyam. He answers clearly, saying that if you say that the fire has spoken, it does not mean that the fire has spoken. The deity governing the fire has spoken. Even in Tamil we used to say Ahupayar. Oor Kondadiyadu. If you say that, it does not just define something, the constructed structure of the place. The house is now happy. It does not mean that the brick, the wall, the ceiling, the floor is happy. It deals with the indwellers. Likewise, whatever we say, Vayu, then the rain, then the earth, they are speaking means they are not speaking. The deity is governing them, they are speaking. Likewise, even if there is a media, there will be deity for that. Even if it is an electronic media, there will be Vidyut, is the major energy, Vidyut. Is a major energy, electricity, what we call. That is a major energy which is governing all devices. That potency, certainly it will have a deity, which will be crying that it has been misappropriated or unappropriated. So we are doing this task for removing the burden of the deity for multimedia or the technology, which has been lamenting for the so many decades that it has not been properly utilized. If there is a pushpa, and the pushpa, it will have such a sentience, that flower, it will be very happy if it is attributed towards a greater element. That's why in Alvar Sirvai Muli, Sindhupu Mahirum Thiruvengadam, so says Alvar. Even a flower that is falling, it is happy because it is falling on the holy soil of Tirumala. So each and everything that has some sense. See, understanding that we are senseless and everything has sense is real human intellect. But now it is contrary. They are thinking that they are the only sensible things and all the other things are senseless. Each and everything that we see, immobile, that is having a moving force inside it. So, it is a process of sanctification, purification, vitalization and magnification of the same industry in the service of God. And once again, I invite all of you for participation and also for rejoicing the benefits of the channel, the blessings of the God. I think that we shall see soon with so many other myriads of people watching our speech in the hall when we are going to inaugurate the channel, and watching the same in lakhs and lakhs in their own houses, where we are going to bring the abode of the God into their own limited huts. Narayan, Narayan.